Thank you.
Okay, so today we will continue the topic that we didn't finish last week. And then we will discuss the topic today is Taiwan's educational system. So, when we talk about education systems, actually we refer to two components. One is educational administration system. Educational administration systems is how the educational organizations are structured in the central government, in the local government, in the city governments. Now Taiwan has two layers of governments. Formerly Taiwan has three layers: the central government and the provincial or municipal governments, and then the local, we call the county or city governments. But several years ago, about 12 years ago, the Taiwan province has been closed. We can close or solidize. Okay, so now we have two layers. Like in Japan has three. Let's take an example of Japan. Japan is central government, and then the second layer of government is Tokyo City, and then Dao, only one Hokkaido, right? Beihai Dao. Prefecture. prefecture, or in Taiwan we call the counties. Counties, 县. The one closest to us is Okinawa, right? Okinawa County or prefecture. And then under this label of governments is another one. 市, 町, 村. It's another label. So in Taiwan we have the same, very similar. Center. And then we have Taiwan province, Taiwan province, Hokkien province, you know, we still have Hokkien province, yeah. Fujian province, only governs what islands? What islands? Kimoi, and Manchu. These two islands not belong to Taiwan province, but belong to Fujian province. And this Yuan Xia Shi. And then
to govern all the China.
So they still keep, yeah, keep the hope, yeah, keep the plan. So actually, they still think that we still have 36 provinces. 36 provinces in China, 36 provinces, and now we have two provinces. One is Taiwan province, another is Fujian province. Fujian province. And the other one is controlled by the PRC, People's Republic of China. Okay. So now our local government, the second layer or second of local government is five cities and seven counties. And then village, town, and city. So, yeah, the third level, yeah, in Japan, they have cities. And yes, actually, yeah, we have cities. For example, in Pinon County, they have Pinon City, right? They have Pinon City. And they have Chaozhou Town or Hengchun Town, Hengchun Zhen, right? And they have so-called Manzhou Xiang, right? Manzhou Xiang or Zhutian Xiang or Wanwan Xiang, you know, Zhujiao. Sanminju is not actually when we revert the three levels, because the head of this so-called autonomous unit means that all the leaders, including the governors and the representative, are elected. So they are autonomous unit. They are autonomous unit. So the mayor of this city, the mayor of the Machi, mayor of Muna, and the representative, we call that Xiang Min Dai Biao. See, Zheng Min Dai Biao, Shi Min Dai Biao. And here is the councilman, Shi Yuan, Xian Yuan. They are all elected, not appointed by the mayor. But if you say Qu, for example, Kaohsiung, now Kaohsiung has 38 districts. All the district head, Qu Zhang, all the district head are appointed by the mayor, Chen Qu. In Taipei has 12 districts. So all the district head appointed by the mayor. Okay, so they are not autonomous unit.
Oh, because I come from New Taipei City.
Uh-huh.
And okay. Originally it's called Taipei County, right?
Yeah, Taipei.
So we have Xiang.
Yes. But now I transformed. Now transformed into a district.
So originally we elect the Xiang in that year.
Yeah, Xiang, but not anymore.
Now.
Not anymore. Yeah. So they don't have a Xiang in that year. Wait. No. So that triggers a very, very big trouble for the new city government. For example, the same in Kaohsiung. Same in Kaohsiung, because Kaohsiung, the new Kaohsiung cities is merged by the Kaohsiung city, municipality, and the Kaohsiung county. 2 years ago, almost 2 years ago, 1 year and a half ago, a year ago, merged into a new Kaohsiung city. So originally, for example, Gangsan Town, originally they have a Gangsan Town head, Zheng Zhang, and the representative of to Kaohsiung at Gangsan, the council, Zheng Minghai, but now not anymore. Now they only have Gangsan Chuzhang, Gangsan district head, and appointed, not elected, they are appointed by the 市长 Chen Qu, the city mayor Qu Chen. So all these councilmen, all these representatives, and the formerly elected the county head, they lost their job.
They're angry.
That's sure. They very, very angry about that. Mm-hmm. Because when we say that they are autonomous unit, means that they have their budget, they have their money, they have their own money, and they have their personnel. They can appoint any personnel within the county governments. They have that authority, but now not anymore. So they lost it. If they still keep their job, now they are not an elected mayor. They are appointed by the city, the municipality mayor's appointments. So they are the official public servant. Okay.
Huh? No, you forgot your questions.
No problem.
Yeah, yeah.
You can come first.
So in this situation, who supervises the culture you have the department for?
No. City council. City council, 市议会. City Council. City Council. Okay. Okay. So.
That's what I said.
Okay.
We only have 15 counties.
15 counties. We can count from the north.
Yilan.
My memory is only that we have 17. Okay, from the north, Yilan, and then Taoyuan. Right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Human
power, yeah, king. Human, yeah, yeah. Human and Matu.
So we call
Kinmen County. And Matu called Mianjiang County. Mianjiang County, not Matu County. Mianjiang County. So,
so we call
16 and 17.
So we call Tio as a county.
No, city. Tio. Tio is a city. Tio is a city.
So,
yeah, it's a.
So they are standing or stand there?
Yeah, stand there. They are. All these are stand there. But now, actually, they are stand there with the Taipei City, Taipei, New Taipei City, and Taizhong City, Tainan City, and Kaohsiung City. They are the same. They are the same. All in the same level. Yeah. So actually, now we have. Two layer government. Okay? So education belongs these two layer governments, not three layer governments. In Japan, their education belongs to three levels governments. So in the Shenzhen City, village, town and city, they don't have authority over education. No. All the schools belong to these layers. These layers. And most of the higher education institutions belong to the central one. The central one. But in Taipei, they have three universities. Taipei City, only Taipei City, they have three universities. Taipei Zhuan sports, physical education institution, and Taipei merchandise, and the Taipei University of Taipei Municipal University of Education, Taipei City Jiaoyu Dachi. So they have three Taipei cities. Only Taipei cities governs three, because Taipei cities are very rich. They are rich, so they can afford three universities or colleges. And Kaohsiung City has one called the Kaohsiung Open University. Have you heard that? Kaohsiung Open. Open University. You know? Never heard that?
Yeah.
Kaohsiung Open University.
What is open?
Yeah, what is open?
Yeah.
You know, do you know the biggest university in the world? Which one? Not Harvard, not the Columbia. Or Stanford, no. Or London, no. The biggest university is the Open University in London. In London. In England, yeah. And located in London. Because it has 6,400,000 students. Because his students located in the world, every continent. Every continent has its own. We call that Yingguo Kaifang Dachi. Kaifang Dachi. So we call that Kaohsiung Kongzhong Dachi. Kongzhong Dachi, we call them Open University. right? Open university.
Yeah.
If you go to the MRT, 高雄 MRT, 高雄捷运 Mass Rapid Transportation Systems, if you go to the red line and the orange line, the construction is the plus is the Formosa station, right? Yeah. In the station, they have their campus there. Branch campus there. Yeah, 光之穹顶，在光之穹顶的旁边 ，very nearby 光之穹顶 ，and they have their campus there. So we can rent their classroom there if we want to make our facilities broader than what we have now. Okay, so Kaohsiung has one university. University, that's an open university. But actually, the central government has one open university, 国立空中大学, National Open University. So in Taiwan, we have two open universities. One is national, and one is Kaohsiung, city level. Okay? So all the elementary schools and junior high schools belong to these levels. But these five municipalities govern the senior high education levels. Senior high, 高中高职。这五个都会区它会管高中高职。可是其他的就不会。These authorities didn't only govern the junior high and the elementary schools and the kindergarten but only these five cities govern the senior high school and senior vocational high school. Okay?And then the higher education, most of the higher education are governed, no matter they are public or private, are governed by the central government. That means the Ministry of Education. Okay, so, last week we skipped these topics. Something about Taiwan.Let me put it as a quiz, that you answer the questions. What is the national symbol of Taiwan or Republic of China? The official name of our country is Republic of China, ROC, right? And the symbols, yeah, national symbols. The brown flower. Brown flower.The brown flower, 秀一样的吗？有吗
？Yeah,
brown flower. That's a brown flower. And you know what it stands for? What is it stand for?
Office?
Huh?
Office?
No, the office.No, this originally stands for the whole China. Whole China, we have too many countries. Yeah, if you count in China, wow, too many.
So it's a province.
No. It's stands for the unit that the traditional Chinese to count the time. The time. The whole days.Traditionally, Chinese people count the unit of time is by how do you call that?
Inches.
One day, how the and this one, this unit stands for now is 2 hours.
2 hours,
right?
Yes.
So when you watch the traditional kung fu movies, there are one people that during the midnight, and he was as a security people, and he would hitting the drum and remind people that be careful, there are fire, right? And then say that now is or 丑时, right? So the 24 hours, but according to Chinese, traditional Chinese units are divided into 12 units, not 24 hours. Okay, so this is our national flag. We all know that, but you might not know that. So especially last month we have Olympic in London, right? And it's an issue that for our athlete, our representative team, that they are not allowed to wear any symbols in their body, in their dress. They only the so-called Chinese Taipei, right? Now the official name of our team is Chinese Taipei team, not the ROC team or not the Taiwan team, or because of the politics. You may all know that. Okay, next slide. So this is the geography of Taiwan. Geography of Taiwan, now we are here. We are here in Kaohsiung. So there are three islands here. The island here, right? For the Diao Yi Tai. Now it's the hard issue. The hard issue that there are many strikes, many protests in China. So Japanese are safe here. Taiwan, but now it's dangerous in China. Okay, next. Okay, now the people in Taiwan are composed of three majors. One, I think more than 80% are Hello people. How do you say that in Chinese, in Chinese Mandarin? Hello. I think most of us are Hello. Sometimes say that or most of them are from Fujian province, and they originally emigrated from the middle of China. So they call them Hollow people. And another one is Hakka people. Hakka people between 10 to 15%. And then the immigrant, called a new immigrant.
Taiwanese dialect, Hakka dialect,
English.
Yeah.
and Aboriginal dialect. But even though these endeavors, these languages are dying. Yeah. Fewer and fewer younger generations can speak fluent Hakka languages, Holo languages, and even the Aboriginal languages. So that's very, I think, very pity, very pitiful. And I'm very surprised to find out that because I visited Okinawa many times. And 2 years ago, when I asked the teachers in Okinawa, said that in Okinawa you should have your own dialect, your own language. Yeah, they speak, but I asked them that whether you teach the Okinawa original language in schools, they say no, never. They never speak. They never teach the Okinawa languages, the Ochikoyu, in their schools. But this year, I went to Okinawa in July, the end of July, with the mayor Chen. 我跟陈局市长, 7月底的时候, 我们去那个 Okinawa, 去 Okinawa. And this time, I found out. Because we met the mayor of Okinawa City, and we met the deputy commissioner of Okinawa camp. Okinawa, 我们见到了冲绳市的市长, 还有 冲绳县的副县长. Both of them all speak that they want to encourage. They want to encourage their younger generation to speak their own languages in school. So this is my first time to hear about that they want to promote the revitalization of their dialect. But when I was a child, if I speak Taiwanese dialect in schools, and then yeah, my classmate would point me out and then tell the teachers, and I have to punish to get fined $1 if I speak Taiwanese style. Oh, 讲方言, you must be fined $1, $1 NT. Okay. So now let's continue with our slide. Okay. So two topics, and then the third one is we will do some comparison with other countries' systems. Okay. This is the educational administration systems in we don't have it. In the central government, under the premier is prime minister. In Japan, we call a prime minister.
How do you call it in Japan?
Ministry of Education, but you don't call the Shoyu Bu. No, you don't call that. You call the Mon. Mon. Right? But actually, in English, if you found out the English name, title of Japanese, the center unit who governs the education, they call the Ministry of Education Culture and Science. Three content. So not just education. Not just education. But here, originally the Ministry of Education in Taiwan governs culture, governs science, but now they separate into a different ministry. Now we have a Ministry of Culture. Right? 我们现在有文化. Who is the minister?
Dong
Yintang.
Yeah.
Dong Yintang. So in Taiwan, we have Ministry of Culture. And then we have Ministry of Science. But we don't call them the Ministry of Science. We call them the Council of Science. Wokewei, National Council. Right? 国家科学委员会 NSC National Science Council 国家科学委员会 So it happens in many countries. For example, in France, in their central government, they have Ministry of Higher Education. Just higher education, they have one ministry. And then another ministry is a Ministry of National Education, 国民教育部, 高等教育部, and then Ministry of Sports and Juvenile, 青少年运动. Oh, so in their central government, they have many ministries. But now our governments try to consolidate. So in the end of this year, the Qinghui, yes, and the Qiwei, Sports Commission, Sports of Youth, will merge into a Ministry of Education. Because we are a small country, right? We are a small country in this regard of China. The midst of China, we don't talk about that. Yeah. But yeah, just in Taiwan, we are a small country. We don't need to have so many ministries in the central government, because we have to spend much money here. Yeah. Right? To pay their salaries, yes. Okay, let's take a break. We want to subscribe the textbook. We have only one textbook. For I just this Lao Wai Ai Taiwan from the eyes of a foreigner. It's only one. Now we will discuss many times in our class. So, who wants to buy this? Only one. Yeah, because this one you can learn on the website of the Ministry of Education. So, only this one.
It's necessary.
Yeah.
How much? Is it, how much about less than 300? 多少?
200多.
So we can both together. Yeah.
No. That, this book is statistics. So you don't have to buy this one. You don't have to buy this one. You just log on this website. This website. So all you need is to buy this one or to borrow this one. Yeah, if you can borrow from the library, I don't know whether they have or not. Yeah. This one pretty neat. A pretty new book. So I think that the price is across to 300. 250? What is it? Okay. I guess less than $380. So could you raise your hand if you want to buy?
I will then take it here.
Yeah, they can buy it for you. Yeah, we will subscribe on the K bookstore. Okay. K bookstore. Okay, so let's return to the topic. So now the name of Japan's Ministry of Education, they call it the Munmonbu Hexue Sheng. Because they include the culture and science. Okay, so let's go back to our educational administration systems. So on the left one, Ministry of Education, under the Ministry of Education is national schools at all levels. National Social Education Organization. So in Kaohsiung we have a Social Education Hall. That means that to carry out the social education for adults, not just for students. Because students, you can receive your education in schools, but for the adults, for the working people, they don't have place to go except the cramming schools. Cramming schools, they charge a higher fees. So the social education halls, they provide a variety of courses during the night, during the weekends, for them to have so you have that in Indonesia? You're from Indonesia, yeah. So you have something like this, the social education hall for the adults, for the working people, if you want to listen to some lectures from the scholars or from the university professors. Okay. You have something like this? In Taiwan, almost every city we have a social education hall to provide a social education. Because education we divide into three parts. One is the school education, one is the family education, and one is the social education. Family education, the major responsibility is parents, right? Parents, you must have some education within your household. And school education, now you are receiving school education. And social education is We use the social education hall or some other that we might talk about that later. Okay, and then private universities, colleges, and junior colleges. Wenzhou is belong this category. And then private senior secondary schools. Okay, and then that's how we just talk about the municipalities. Now we have five municipalities. Taipei, in Taipei City, Taichung City, Tainan City, Kaohsiung City. We have five municipalities. And then we have 17, just counted, the counties, city, governments. And all they govern a certain kind of education institutions. And more schools. Okay, next page. And then, now the second level, we take Kaohsiung City as an example, because I was the commissioner. How do you call that? How
How do you call the 教育部长 that is the minister of our education? And how do you call the, within the cities, the cities usually they call the 教育局 education bureau.Bureau. So the head of the education bureau is the 教育局长. How to call it? In the website, they like to call them a director. Director General.Director General. But in the Western countries, usually they call them like this, use this term, Superintendent. Very long words. Superintendent. They call the 教育局长, call them Superintendent.But in the big city, very big city like New York, like Chicago, like Los Angeles, or like Paris or London, usually we call them commissioner. Commissioner of education. 社会教育科 and then division of physical and sanitary education. Physical education. What is physical education? What is physical education? Yeah, play ball. And you have the physical education class. So that's the only for school physical education. And the sanitary education. That means to maintain the healthy environment within schools. 体育保健科，体育保健科或体育卫生科 ，OK。And then this is the only one in Taiwan that we have this division of educational technology. Educational technology. That means to promote the students and teachers within all schools to use the facilities of the audio and visual equipment. I think this one, the Wenzhao is very familiar with this, to use all these equipment, technology equipment. And then these are supporting divisions. For example, personnel, 人事, personnel, accounting, 会计师, accounting, and then, what's that? Oh, ethical. This discipline, this discipline office. That's to maintain the discipline among the civil servants and among the teachers, among the principals, but not students. These are to maintain the disciplines among our colleagues. And then, inspectors, you know inspectors? In Japan, their translation is like this. In Japan, they call this 史学 in Japan. But in Taiwan, we call it 都学, inspectors. When the inspector visits the campus, and everyone in this school must be very nervous because they come to find something that you are not doing good. But most of them, they come to find that you are not doing good. Okay, and then the Ministry Education Office, that's a very strange unit in Taiwan. There's no countries in the world that in schools we can see the military people wearing their uniforms and doing some discipline work. But in Taiwan we have the military people, military officers who are present in our campus to do that because of the martial law. You know martial law? Martial law. Very good.
improving. There, this one I appear strange. The spelling, maybe not right. Martial law. Now this law has been stopped. Has been stopped in 1988 or 1987. This law has been stopped. Has been stopped. But because of the Civil War, because of the Civil War, so at that time our government announced the implementation of martial law. That means that we are in a war time. We're in war time. So our society needs the security, needs the discipline. So the military people can take the job of the policemen. They can go out to do some work to make the society secure. Okay, so because of that, so our campus still have military people here. So many scholars angry about this that we still have the military officers in our schools. In Taiwan now we have only senior high school and colleges and students have military officers. We don't have officers in campus under the senior high schools. Okay, so and then the secretary office. And under these divisions, we have three separate units. One is department of sports, right? Department of sports, and then social center, yeah, social education hall. And then the Family Education Center. Okay, now next slide. Okay, now let's talk about the second topic. Is maybe you will be more familiar with this because you already went through this system. In Taiwan, the school systems in Taiwan, so compare to your systems in Hokkaido, in Jakarta, and in Tokyo. Osaka. So, here, in Taiwan, the kindergarten lasts for 2 years. Kindergarten, 2 years. Are they the same in Hokkaido? Yuqian, 3 years. How about yours? 2 years. 2 years. And how about in Osaka? Yuqian. How many years in your Yuqian?
Kindergarten,
Yuqian.
Yuqian.
Yeah. How many years? You never been to Yuqian? Yeah, 2 years or 3 years? Usually we call them school system chart. So this is a very simple way to understand the school system of different countries. So if you can find out the school system chart, and then you can grasp the most basics, the facts of the school systems in the certain countries. So here they count the numbers of schoolings, and here they show the ages of different levels of schools, begins and ends. So here 6 years, when you are 6 years and you enter in the primary schools or elementary schools, right? So when you are 60 years old, you enter elementary school, Shulabo, right? Shulabo. So the same in Indonesia, when you, because in not every country send their kids to elementary school at age 6. For example, in England, they send the kids into elementary school when they are age 5. Age 5. And in Russia, they send their kids to school age 7. So not uniform.
Yeah.
Here we are 6. We are 6. Yeah, 6 years.
How many years?
Yeah. No. Age. When you are age 6, and then you enter and enter school.
But I enter my elementary school at my age.
No. You can come. Because the way of counting the ages in Taiwan people, Taiwan's way to count the ages is a little bit different from other countries. When we are born, we say that we are 1 year old. Because we count the periods when you are still in your mother's body. That 9 months, we count them are all 1 year. So when you are born and you are 1 year, you are already 1 year old. Including, having babies here. Okay? So when you are 6 years, 6 years old, you enter school. And then you study 6 years in elementary school, right? 6 years. 6 years, right? You know what is
bill.
But in Japan, you don't do this, right? You use this. 知道吗？在日本这样他们看不懂，他们看不懂这个，他们要用这个，没有他们不懂这样，这是台湾的才看得懂。哦，对，台湾才了，哪才了？ Indonesia, you use the this is 6. This is 6.
Different way.
Yeah, simplify the numbers. Okay. So after 6 years of studies in elementary school, and then you enter the junior high school. Right? Junior high school. Do you have to test some kind of examination to enter the junior high schools?
No.
No. You don't have to.
You have?
No. You went to private school, very high competitive school.
We have the seventh grade.
Okay.
Oh, in order to talk about the junior school, they have a small community part of the school that they.
Oh yes, yes, yes. We call the screening test. Screening test.
Okay.
Screening test. Screening test. Okay. Within these two levels, our government think that all the students must be equal. All class must be equal. So you cannot, you are not supposed to do the ability grouping. I think the same in Japan. The same in Japan. Within the elementary school and junior high schools, you are not supposed to do the ability grouping. That means that these groups are very elite students, and that groups are common bad students. No, you are not supposed to do that. But some schools, especially the private junior high schools, because they want to cluster all the bright students into a one group, and then they can teach them the very difficult materials, and then to help them to pass the entrance examinations. So they do that, but that's illegal. That's illegal. Yeah. If you are you got called by the pusher, supervisor or inspectors, and then the principals would have a big troubles. Yeah, a big trouble. So that's illegal. Illegal to do the ability groupings. But after senior high school is allowed. It is allowed to do that. Because we want to protect our young students. We don't want to labelize them. Labelize. You know that? We don't want to labelize that, oh, you are good students, or you are best students, or you are perform badly. Labelize. Okay, so 3 years in junior high. So we don't have an entrance examination. But before 9 year basic compulsory education, yes, we have an entrance examination. But not now. And then after nine years of, this 9 years is compulsory education. And after these 3 years of studies, and then you have to take the examination to enter, this is a senior high school. And this is a senior vocational high school. And then this is a junior, 5 year junior college. So, Wenzhou, we have a Wenzhou section right here. And then I think most of you are here, right? You, when you graduate from junior high school,
You went to senior high school, either senior high school or senior vocational high school, right?
Yeah.
And how about your sisters in Japan and Indonesia? You had 3 years in junior high?
Yeah.
Yeah, the same. The same, and the same. Okay? And then you have the entrance examination. You want to go on to the senior high school? Oh, yeah. Okay. So how many years in your in Indonesia for senior high school?
6 years.
Oh, 6 years, the same. So you have the same, yeah, the divided. The academic high school and then vocational high school, they are separate or they are combined?
Separate.
Separate.
But we don't have 5 years college.
Oh, you don't have? You don't have that. Okay. In the world, only Taiwan and Japan have a 5 year junior colleges. Only Taiwan, I think, and Japan. 5 years. So these are 5 years. Junior college is the invention of Taiwan. It's an invention of Taiwan. Yeah, we have that earlier than Japan.
Why we have this?
Because the first 3 years is parallel to the high school years. And then, because we had that in about 1960, it was 49 years old, we had that. At that time, we don't have, the government didn't have that much money to have the 4 year colleges. So they invite higher education institutions, which combine the senior high school and higher education within one institution. So compare one lab in senior high school and one lab in the higher education institutions to save money. To save money and to prepare the mid-level human power. So that's why. But now, the people don't like that. People want to be a baccalaureate, a college degree, not just associate degree. So that's why the numbers of students in junior colleges are now declining. Okay? So you have, when I asked that, when I asked her did they have senior high schools with both academic round? So this senior high school is focused on academic studies, right? And then vocational high school focused on vocational round. Two-way. This one is only for your applications. This idea is the European idea of schools, of senior high schools. But when the United States were established 200 more years ago, they are very, very upset about these systems. They think that this is a kind of a classified of societies, because all the people who follow the academic route are from the affluent families. They are rich people, so they study academic, they study Latin, they study mathematics, they study debate, they study speech. They don't have to make money by their own. And the vocational high school is only for the working people, for poor people, for the farmers. So they think that this idea is not a good idea in the United States. So when the United States, they established their countries, their high schools, they call it the comprehensive high schools. That means that within that school, they provide academic courses and vocational courses together, and for you to choose. These are options, like the cafeteria, like the cafeteria. Whatever you want to take, you can take calculus, which even, and you can take the mechanic, chisho shou, or hairdresser, meno meno. Whatever you want, all the academic, all the vocational courses are together, and for you to choose. So that's an American idea. That's an American idea. And Japan and Taiwan and even China, they follow the European idea. So that's why, and I think that I know that Indonesia also follow the European idea, not American ideas. So in the senior high schools, we have several routes. Several routes, academic route, vocational route, and then we had Taiwan, we had mentioned a 5-year junior colleges route. Okay? But now our government tried to enforce the 12-year basic education. That means that our government decided that we want to switch from the European directions to the American style of senior high school. That we want to combine all these vocational and academic raw courses together within one school. Is this a good idea or not? Nobody knows. But they are the option, their choose, their choice. Okay?
Any questions? I think each school, there should be more and more teachers and understand more. They should have the ability to teach students the vocational skills.
The material must be very different because of their orientations and then what they need. If the students are vocational oriented and they don't have to spend so much time to study English or mathematics, they just study the basic level of mathematics or basic level of English. They don't have to spend that much courses.
Because no one
teaching
or equipment.
Or equipment.
Yeah.
So it takes time. It takes time because the vocational high schools, their equipment, especially the mechanic, or some other mechanical the equipments are very expensive. So for the senior high schoolers to equip these equipments, that's it takes a huge amount of money. So it takes time. So now that the plan the government what to do is that within this zone, within this Zhaoshengqu, this zone, you must promise that you have all kinds of schools, the academic high schools, vocational high schools, 5-year junior colleges, special education schools, all these kind of schools must be there for the students to choose. Because now, after 2 years, there will not be the so-called the basic examinations, 基层. There's no entrance examination anymore. Two years from now, there won't be any basic education test. Okay, so let's continue. And then the colleges, after the senior high school education, and then the colleges. Normally, the colleges last for 4 years, right? In Japan, 4 years. In Jakarta, 4 years. But in Japan, no, in Europe, most of higher education, most colleges last for only 3 years. In France, in England, in UK, usually 3 years. But Germany lasts for 4 years. But less than 20% of German college students graduate within 4 years. Less than 20%. Less than 20% of German college students graduate within 4 years. Because they don't want to graduate that early. So when they study 1 year or 2 years, and then they go abroad. No, they don't get anything. Their tuition free. German and France, their tuition is free. They don't have to pay tuition. Yes, they have only two time chance to pass the test. If they fail two times, and then they are kicked out. So they don't want to take risk. They want to prepare themselves enough then to take the test. Okay.